Today we're discussing Coca-Cola, some history, some facts, and a general sense of the company. Our story begins in 1885 when a former Confederate colonel named John Pemberton created a drink that served as a replacement for morphine. He was wounded in the war and didn't want to rely on morphine, so this drink helped to ease him off of it. He pitched this drink also to help with things like nerve disorders and headaches, almost a cure-all elixir. It originally included alcohol, but with the dawn of Prohibition, Pemberton created a non-alcoholic formula. It was called Coca-Cola because it contained extract from the coca plant, which also creates the narcotic cocaine. The amount of cocaine in the early days is incredibly minimal, though. It was also present in most other medicines of the time as well. The last traces of cocaine were removed by 1929. Some of the videos I'm using here are courtesy of a Comedy Central segment of Drunk History retelling this account. Anyways, back to the origin. After Pemberton created Coca-Cola, it becomes a little confusing. Different businesses were creating the drink with various agreements with Pemberton. He owned the name Coca-Cola but allowed different manufacturers to use his formula. There wasn't much proof of any of this, mostly being verbal agreements. Eventually, the formula and the name were purchased by a businessman by the name of Asa Candler, who really launched Coca-Cola into fame and later became mayor of Atlanta, Georgia. There are several buildings and monuments in Atlanta named after him. How Candler got the rights to Coca-Cola is a little mysterious, as he was contested by Pemberton's son and another co-owner that claims her signature was forged. It's hard to know what really happened, but one tale, perhaps an urban legend, says that Candler bought the rights from John Pemberton's wife at his funeral, so that the younger Pemberton wouldn't have a chance to deny him.
Well, son, this is Fred in a chain. Because you have me,